The docking of Orbital Science Corporation's Cygnus vehicle to the space station has been delayed for a few days. Orbital and NASA decided together to postpone the vehicle's approach, rendezvous, grapple, and berthing until after the upcoming Soyuz operations are complete. Cygnus launched on its Antares rocket from the Mid-Atlantic Regional Spaceport at NASA's Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia on Wednesday, and it's bringing to the station on this demonstration mission 1,300 pounds of cargo. It was originally scheduled to dock on Sunday, but when the vehicle established direct data contact with the space station, some of the data received had values that were unexpected, which caused Cygnus to reject the data. We have here with us via phone Bruce Manners with NASA's Commercial Orbital Transportation Services Program to give us an update on Cygnus's docking plan. Bruce, thanks so much for joining us.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity to come out and talk to you folks. If you'd like, I can certainly walk you through real quick the plan for the next few days and what will ultimately result in the Cygnus spacecraft berthing with the International Space Station.
That would be great, right, Bruce. Now, yeah, if you could walk us through what's going on, that would be perfect.
Sure. As you said, they did have a little data discrepancy issue that between Cygnus and the International Space Station that was discovered very late Sunday. In the last 24 hours, I've watched and participated with the orbital science team working through their replan and development of a software patch to correct that problem. And in the last 24 hours, I've just seen some tremendous amount of work both here and at the mission control in Houston as the orbital folks put together that software patch. It's a very small, little simple fix. They tested that, validated that, and in ground systems. And then really coordinated an immense amount of work also coordinating that and communicating those fixes and validating with it. That's all the correct thing to do with the teams back in Houston as well. So that's been just a tremendous team effort, and they've done a fantastic job getting that already. The thought right now is, as he said, they waved off. We initially were thinking we were going to be doing the berthing attempts early tomorrow morning, but with the Soyuz coming in, I think everyone felt that a little bit of time and breather after the flurry of activity the last 24 hours is the best thing to do and give the teams an opportunity to get some rest. And, you know, this is a new vehicle, so a little additional time flying in space and learning how it operates and how we operate with it and how we communicate with the space station program and everybody is not a bad thing. So the plan now is they're looking at a first opportunity to come in with the space station. It would be on Saturday, on the 28th. That's the first opportunity. There's an awful lot of planning that has to take place between now and then, so they'll have to work that out with the space station program. They have to finish up with the Soyuz berth or docking, as you said, on Wednesday, and then the flight control teams will really work into the detailed planning, the logistics of how that's all going to come together for the Cygnus opportunity, which, as you said, will be this weekend. The earliest opportunity anybody can conceive right now is Saturday. So hopefully we can get it done Saturday, but if not, we do have more time after that.
So the work that the teams have been doing here on the ground has gone well and looks like they'll be ready for things earlier than Saturday, but just because of the Soyuz schedule and giving the crew some downtime before they move from one activity to another.
That's right. Yep, they want to make sure the crew has had an opportunity to get some rest, and also the ground teams overall have also been working very hard, so those folks also need a little bit of rest.
Can you tell us, you know, I guess the Soyuz docking is a little different than the Cygnus berthing. It's not the same approach to the space station, right?
No, they both are entirely different systems. In fact, berthing to the space station and a docking to the space station are two fundamentally different approaches. If you think about it with a berthing, what happens is with Cygnus, they will come up, they'll fly close to the space station and come to a point where they will just go to essentially a hold and a stop point, and the crew using the Canadian robotic arm will reach out and grab and grapple the Cygnus spacecraft and then bring it in to a berthing with the space station. The docking, it's entirely different. The robotic arm is not involved at all, and the spacecraft just simply comes up and docks in with the space station on its own without any assist from the crew on board the space station.
So I would think that particularly a berthing takes a lot of focus and energy from the crew, and you want to be sure that they've had plenty of sleep and time to get ready for that.
Absolutely. And there's a lot of planning that goes involved with that. So that's all the work that has to happen once the crews have arrived in the Soyuz. They will go through that. They'll give the crew on board some time to to decompress and get some rest and be ready and ready to go on Saturday, if that can be put together. And if not, then, you know, we have time. The Cygnus spacecraft is in great shape. The systems are all working nominally, and we're very excited and happy with the health of that spacecraft. And so we can give them some time, and we're all working that plan together, and that'll be what's happening the next few days.
That sounds good. Maybe you could also talk a little bit about the fact that this is a demonstration mission. So there's a little bit of a learning curve, I guess, on getting it to the space station.
Absolutely. The COTS program is a demonstration program where the partners, first SpaceX, now Orbital Sciences, are demonstrating their cargo delivery capabilities, which really is, you know, it's a lot like, you know, getting your learner's permit and getting your approved for your driver's license. This is the opportunity for them to fly the vehicle. They have some small amounts of cargo, but it's all non-essential cargo, and we can really all work together and learning how to fly the spacecraft, how to bring them in, how to integrate them with the mission control centers, demonstrate that their services are good and that they can deliver the cargo. And then ultimately under our CRS contract, they will be delivering cargo just on a regular basis, a lot like the U.S. mail or FedEx.
And I know NASA is certainly never cavalier about any vehicle approaching the space station, but there's probably even a little bit of an extra layer of precaution for a demonstration mission like this. Is that right?
That's very true. We've had months and months of meetings and discussions and design reviews and reviews with a safety review panel, all to bring us, culminated into where we are now. As they made that software patch last night, we've had an awful lot of discussions and working with the safety community, the engineering community, the operations community, and that's all the work that happened over the last 24 hours and to get that software patch approved by all parties and everybody understands exactly where we are. It's a complicated system, both from a procedural and process perspective and also just the systems themselves. The International Space Station and Cygnus spacecraft are complex spacecraft that need to work and talk well together. And right now, we think we're in a good situation for berthing this weekend.
That's great. Is there a time limit on getting it to the space station, or a number of limit on the number of times it can attempt a docking or a berthing?
Ultimately, that's limited by fuel, but Cygnus spacecraft, because it doesn't have as much cargo as we would normally intend to fly on it, it is well fueled. There are limits. I don't know the number offhand, but we are good for several attempts. So we think we're well positioned right now to keep going. We can do this for pretty much, I don't want to say as many times as we need to, but we have more attempts now than we will have on a normal CRS mission when you fully get loaded up with cargo. So right now we're fuel rich, and we think we are good to go.
So if every reason to expect that it will be getting to the space station soon, just giving the crew some time to get through with the Soyuz activities before we try again.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you so much, Bruce. We really appreciate you calling in. This was very helpful.
Yep. Thank you very much. Appreciate your time. And go Cygnus. We're looking forward to good berthing this weekend.
Good luck.